Friends, in this video, we are discussing test the convergence of summation n is equal to 1 to infinite square root of n cube plus 1 minus square root of n cube minus 1. Similarly, square root of n power 4 plus 1 minus square root of n power 4 minus 1. Here you have n power 3 plus 1. Here you have n power 4 plus 1. Next problem, n square plus 1. Next problem, n power 1 plus 1. So powers only change in this case. Next, you observe here also 3, 4, 2, 1. To solve these type of the problems. Okay. First of all, you see, instead of 3, 4, 2, 1, I am considering directly one number, one variable like a constant. Constant here 1, 2, 3, 4 you have. So I am taking like this one, summation into the power of p plus 1 minus summation square root of n to the power of p plus 1 minus square root of n power p minus 1. Just you see, if we put p is equal to 1, you will get this one, p is equal to 2, this one, p is equal to 3, p is equal to 4. Okay, now I will solve this problem. Based on this, we can check this is a convergent or divergent. Similarly, you see here, n to the power of 3, here just you don't have minus 1. N to the power of 4, you don't have minus 1 or plus 1. These are also similar only. If we solve this one, based on this, we can check whether 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 are convergence or divergence together. Okay. Earlier, we discussed to test the convergence of the given series. First, what we have to do? We have to apply limit n tends to infinite. Limit n tends to infinite for a given series. You see here you have n to the power of p plus 1 minus square root of n power p minus 1. So if you applied infinite, infinite power of p plus 1 means infinity. Again infinite minus 1. So what I am taking means here first n to the power of p I am taking common. Then you will have n to the power of p by 2 outside. Excuse me. Now this will become 1 plus 1 by n to the power of p, and here also you can take common, so it will become overall minus square root of 1 minus 1 by n to the power of p. Now as n tends to infinite, 1 by n goes to 0, so 1 by n power p also goes to 0. So 1 plus 0 means what? Square root 1. This will become square root 1. Again this will become square root 1. This is like n to the power of p by 2 means infinite. So square root 1 minus square root 1 gives what? As n tends to infinity, it goes to what? 0. So limit of the series is goes to 0. So it may be convergence or divergence. Okay. It may be convergence or divergence. How to test the series is convergent, divergent means? First of all, we have like geometric series. Is the given series is in the form of summation r to the power of n? Tell me. No. Next. Is the given series is directly in the form of summation 1 by n to the power of p directly? Check it here. Is it like 1 by n power p directly? No. So we cannot apply geometric series test. We cannot apply p series test. So go for limit comparison test. So in the limit comparison test, what we have un means un is equal to square root of n power p plus 1 minus square root of n power p minus 1, which is a positive series only. Because you put n is equal to 1 here, root 2 minus 0. So root 2 is greater than 0. So this is for n is equal to 1, positive. N is equal to 2, all these all are what? Positive only. So it is a series of positive terms. But here you see, in the limit comparison test, generally we have to choose a Vn case. But it is what type of the, here what we are getting, if you are choosing Vn is nothing but again you are getting n to the power of p by 2 only. But Un by Vn if you are taking, you are unable to get the solution. In this case, this is a root function, so you have to racialize with their conjugate. If you are racialized with their conjugate, what will happen means, here the term won't be changed. If you are racialized this function, the term won't be changed. So I am racializing with conjugate, then n power p plus 1 minus n power p minus 1 square root of n power p plus 1 minus square root of n power p minus 1 by, this is conjugate means, plus n power p plus 1 plus square root of n power p minus 1. Now this is a minus b. You see a minus b into what you have like a plus b by a plus b form. So what we will get here? A square minus b square by a plus b form. So square root whole square. Okay, a minus b means a square. A is this one only, na? So you will have n to the power of b plus 1 square root whole square. So this term will be getting cancelled. Minus again n to the power of p minus 1 square root whole square. The term will be getting cancelled. Divided by you have a plus b. What is a here? N to the power of p plus 1 plus square root of n to the power of p minus 1. Here you see this is what value now? Un. So this is n power p plus 1 minus n power p minus 1. So n power p minus n power p getting cancelled. 1 minus of 1 is nothing but what? 2. So what is the term? Your remaining term is 2 by square root of n to the power of p plus 1 plus square root of n to the power of p minus 1. Now here you see un is in the form of f of n by g of n form. Un is in the form of f of n by g of n. It is containing numerator. See here, this un, original un and this un is also both are same. But here we are unable to test the convergence. Na? You cannot compare and we cannot do the directly problem. So we cannot apply the limit comparison problem directly. So in this case, just we are multiplied with its conjugate function. Then it is converted into this form. Now this is also series of positive terms only. Can we choose vn in this case? Yes. What is the vn here? Highest nth term. Is there anything here? Nth power? No. So I can take n power 0 is nothing but 1 by, here you see this is sum of the two series. Sorry, sum of the two terms. One is the square root of n power p plus 1. Another one is square root of n power p minus 1. So from these two, can you take a same common term? Yes. What is the term you can take? Square root of n power p. From this and from this. Overall, square root of n power p we are getting. So 1 by square root of n power p we can write as n to the power of p by 2. So you see vn is in the form of 1 by n power p only, na? Summation 1 by n power p. What is p here in place of p? What we have? P by 2. So if p by 2 is greater than 1, you can say the series is, if p by 2 is greater than 1, then you can say the series is what? Convergent. If p by 2 is less than or is equal to 1, series is divergent. Earlier we discussed the p series test. Okay. So by p series test, vn is convergent for p greater than p by 2 greater than 1, p by 2 less than or is equal to 1 is divergent. Simply what we can write, p by 2 greater than 1 is nothing but what? For p greater than 2 convergent, for p less than or is equal to 2 is divergent. Okay. Next, limit comparison test. Earlier we discussed, na? So you have to apply the limit n tends to infinite. See, limit to n tends to infinite un by vn we have to apply. Okay. For this, limit to n tends to infinite un by vn is equal to limit n tends to infinite 2 by square root of 1 plus 1 by n to the power of p plus square root of 1 minus 1 by n to the power of p. Now into what we have here, v by divided by vn. Vn is what we have. Vn is equal to 1 by root n power p. No? So you can write this as square root of n power p minus 1. Just I have written a denominator as a reciprocal. Now you see, actually this is what here, summation un into vn. Here you have n to the power of square root of n power p outside. Now this square root of n power p getting cancelled. Now if you are applied the limit n tends to infinite, 1 by n is goes to 0. So 1 by n power p is n by n power p means 1 by n whole to the power of p. 1 by n power p is nothing but 1 by n whole to the power of p. So 1 by n goes to 0. So what we have here, root 1 plus 0 plus root 1 minus 0. So here you have like 2 by 2. 2 by 2 is equal to 1, which is non-zero. Now, since vn is what here? Since summation vn is equal to 1 by n to the power of p by 2 is convergent for p greater than 2, divergent for p less than or is equal to 2. Therefore, summation un is also convergent for p greater than 2, divergent for p less than or is equal to 2. By what test here? By limit comparison test. So now we have a p value finally. But now the problems, earlier we discussed like different problems like this. Now you see, now this is, we have like a summation square root of n to the power of 3 plus 1 minus square root of n power p minus 1. So here what you have p value is 3. When this square root of n power p plus 1 minus square root of n power p minus 1 is convergent, earlier we discussed now. So for p greater than 2, tell me what is the p here now? 3. So which is greater than 2. Therefore what you can say, this series is convergent by limit comparison test. Now what is the p value here? P is equal to what here you have? 2. P is here 4, which is greater than 2. Therefore what you can say? Convergent. Next, here you have n to the power of 1. 1 means here P is 1, which is less than 2. Less than 2, therefore what we can say? Divergent by limit comparison test. See, for these all the problems, you will get limit is non-zero only. Next, you see n square minus 1 you have. Square root of n square plus 1 you have. So this P is equal to what here? 2. Even less than or is equal to 2, which is what? Divergent. Okay, next you have square root of n plus 1 minus root n. Instead of root n, root n minus 1, whatever it may be, if it is only root n you have, then you will have the un by vn square root of n plus 1 plus square n only. This form only here. Again, you will have a vn is equal to 1 by root n. 1 by root n is nothing but p is equal to what? 1 by 2. P is equal to 1 by 2 is nothing but by p test what you can say? Less than 1, divergent. Vn is divergent. If you are applied the limit n tends to infinity, un by vn, you will have 1 by this root n getting cancelled. 1 by n coefficient is 1. Root 1 is nothing but 1 plus again root 1. Means root 1 plus root 1 is nothing but root 2. Root 1 plus root 1 is nothing but 1 plus 1. 1 plus 1 is nothing but 2, which is not is equal to 0. Since Vn is what? Divergent. Therefore, this series is also divergent. Now, what you can say? This series also divergent. Because what you are having? Vn is 1 by root n square. Now, can you say one more example? Seventh one. Summation n is equal to 1 to infinite square root of n cube plus 1 minus root n cube. What about the Vn you will have here? 1 by square root of n cube. So this is convergent. Next, one more problem. Okay, tell me this one. Summation n is equal to 1 to infinity square root of n power 4 plus 1 minus square root of n power 4. Can you guess what is the vn in this case? 1 by root n to the power of 4. So nothing but you will have p is equal to root 4 is nothing but 2. P is equal to greater than 1. Therefore vn is convergent in this case. Like this, we can solve the problems. Okay. Now, are you understood this one? These type of the problems, you see, whenever numerator, only the series is containing numerator, and also series is containing numerator, and also it is goes to zero. Numerator only it is containing, it having a square roots, and it is goes to zero. Better to rationalization. If you rationalized also, the function won't be changed. Okay, no? Then like this, we have to solve these type of the problems. Thank you for watching this video.